Let's talk about why I can't see your faces today. One word, coronavirus. But this scenario, two questions are very critical to ask. First, how are we going to prepare our bodies to fight a future pandemic if it's awaiting for us? Second, is there a possibility that we can avoid a pandemic in future altogether? The answers lie here. Bats. Yes. Also, the reason that I'm dressed like a woman in black today. But bats are the source of coronavirus that are considered as the source of coronavirus. But in fact, in presence of a large amount of virus, bats don't get sick. However, from our own experience, we know that humans, when we expose them towards this virus, we tend to have symptoms. We might even get to hospital. But let us dig deeper into that. Consider a human cell. Now, in presence of the virus, the cell senses a danger. And what it does, it activates large amount of proteins, molecules, which are molecules called as NLRP3, which in turn then activates another set of molecules called IFNs. These IFNs stimulate an inflammation response in your bodies, by which you can actually fight the virus and you get sick, you get swollen, or other type of sickness. But if this regulation is not, if this type of response is not regulated properly in your body, you might have different kind of diseases, even tissue damage, and worst case, cancer or even death. On the other hand, in bats, this activation of this NLRP3 molecule is less in presence of virus, thus limiting its inflammatory response caused by these IFNs. As a result, there is no tissue damage, no sign of diseases in bats. Instead of finding a way to fight this virus like we are trying, they just tolerate it somehow. Viruses don't know any bounds when it comes to evolution, and so do bats, thus making them very good for studying to prevent future pandemic and to help in drug development as well. I, as a chemist, believe that it requires a collaborative scientific approach so that we can see whether to resist or tolerate to achieve global One Health system. What do you think? Thank you.